I'd put that woman against 25 PhDs from the finest Ivy League schools of your own picking. Here's why. This woman with fourth grade education had a postgraduate degree in a discipline you and I would call common sense. Someone said, you know the trouble with common sense? It ain't as common as it once was. My mother would tell me every single day, if you want to be a great person, Nito, you must first walk hand in hand and side by side with people who are great. You want to be happy? Hang around people who are happy. You want to be successful? Be in the midst of people who are successful. You want to be rich? She'd say, find out what poor people do and don't do it.
Nito Cobain is an amazing success story. As a teenager, he came to America with no money, no contacts, and almost no knowledge of the English language. Through perseverance, uncommon common sense, and tremendous drive, he has accomplished more than most people ever dream. He is chairman of several businesses, including the Great Harvest Bread Company, with 218 stores in 40 states. He serves on the boards of several national organizations, including Lazy Boy and BB&T. The nation's ninth largest financial institution with $110 billion in assets.
Finish the sentence for me, please. Garbage in? No. Whoever told us that misled us. Truth is, every behavioral study shown recently suggests that garbage in, garbage stays. And garbage gets pregnant and gives birth to triplets. Think how each of us, somewhere in the corner of our brain, we have little pieces of information that if we'd bring them forth and we would analyze them, we'd find the garbage. Like, I can't do that. I've never been good at doing that. That's not one of my good things, and so on. See, I want my children to grow up saying, I can. And I will.
As an educator, Nito is president of High Point University, an undergraduate and graduate institution with 3,200 students from 50 countries. His foundation provides scholarships to 48 deserving young people every year. The Cobain Foundation has granted more than 600 scholarships, worth over $3 million.
January 3rd of this year, I became president. About 4 o'clock in the afternoon, I called maintenance. And I said, I notice when I look towards the library, I see no library. Because you see, there are two trees in front of the library that are blocking the view towards that library. So I said, bring those two trees down. Now I said, wait till after dark. And so the next morning, people came over on campus and they said, oh my God, something is different. What is different? And I heard someone say, look, there's the library. And that was the English teacher. And I said, that's right. That's the library. That's the library that you haven't seen in 10 years. I waited about 3 weeks and I brought all the family together, staff, faculty, and I asked this question. You honestly believe that the most important thing I could have done on my very first day on this campus was to walk around the acreage here and say, let me see. I think we'll bring down that tree. I think we'll cut that tree down. Or do you think that I was trying to send you a magical message that can change your life? And the magical message simply is, when we removed those two obstacles called trees, what did we discover beneath them, behind them, around them? We discovered beauty, architectural beauty. We discovered a source for wisdom, a place for knowledge, a surrounding for people to sit and dialogue and intellectually exchange ideas. So here's the question I asked. I wonder what obstacles are standing in the way of beauty, knowledge, wisdom, and success in your life. What trees exist in your life that if we would just have the guts to remove them, beyond those obstacles, we find everything we ever hoped for. Success and significance, happiness and joy, and anything else you seek.